Okay, praise God. Let's get it in. Look, I want to talk to some of my young people, specifically the young women, because of something I heard. I told you, once I piggyback on something, I just bring clarity about something so we won't be confused about a few things. First of all, you young women, you know, I want you to know, man, that you have a lot of value, okay? You high value. It doesn't make a difference if you're a virgin or not. You know what I'm saying? You got more value when you have more experience. I just want to be clear about something, okay? Now, I'm not talking about, you know, the anatomy, none of that, or the romantic, or the acts, or none of that. I'm just being straightforward with you because of something that was said, okay? So, look, let's understand something. When you meet somebody, if you meet a man, that's when your day start with that man, right? That's when your relationship start. Everything behind you, you know, your mistakes when you was drunk or whatever you did or whatever. Look, you have to know who you are as your identity right now. Okay? You didn't push all that behind. If you run into anybody and they want to sit there and talk about who you've been with and how many times you did this and how many different peoples, have you ever did this in this position? Have you ever did this and you did that? Keep stepping. Simple as that. Keep stepping. You understand? Now, if you meet somebody and he asks you, you say, look, you know, you ever, you know, been in their life, you've ever been prostituting or whatever, whatever. And you say, if you've been in the life, I've been in life. You know, that's far as that's going to go. If he asks you a question like that, you say, is that appropriate? Yeah, that's cool. Long as we don't do no details. I ain't going to ask it. Look, long as we don't go into no details or nothing, man. The problem comes about is that when you volunteer and open your mouth and say something like, you know, I ain't had sex in 20 years. I ain't had sex in 30 years. See, then you open the door in a whole nother area. Is that going to throw him? Is he going to ask you or whatever? If he real? No, he listening to you though. Do he believe you? He believes you because you said it and he don't know you. So he can't judge you. But in the back of his mind, he's probably saying he has doubt. Now you a character he has to pay attention to. But the point I'm trying to make is that when you say guys come out to seek, when guys give this information and you say, well, you guys take things personal. No, it don't be. Listen. Let's be clear about something. The stage is set for clarity here. You know, we give information. Now, this is the pipeline, man. And I think everybody's intent is, for the most part, is good. I don't think nobody is deliberately trying to mislead anybody. I think some people is just misinformed. But also, you talking about the way you think. You're giving more value to something that has no value. What you giving, you making some things, or you're overrating some things. Put it that way. You thinking that because you have somebody on your arm, and because this person is a virgin, or because this person is this, or this person is that, that this person has more value than a person that's been with several different people. And that's not true. And on the contrary. It's the opposite. It's inverse. And the reason why I'm saying it, because the person that's been out there is the person that has made the mistakes. That's the person who has the experience and the person that knows. Some of you guys, older guys who know me, you can imagine taking a virgin around where we were. You know what I'm saying? Can you imagine that? You know, taking a virgin into the crowd or the area or the atmosphere or the environment that we were in back in those days. That's what I'm trying to tell you. And that's not taking, you know, the purity from that woman. No, that's not what I'm saying. I'm saying the experience. And see, what comes, experience comes mistakes and things that you have regrets for, things that you think about, the aftermath. After this happened, damn, I shouldn't have did that, man. See, you carry stuff with you and you go through a healing process. And 9 times out of 10, you don't make those same mistakes, but you have to live with it because you already did. See what I'm saying? That's what you call experience. But virgins, you can take them in a crowd like what we used to be years ago, and you take your eye off of them, and they've been through one door and through that door, and they did this and did that because they'd be thinking this is the way it go, because somebody had been and convinced them that this is the way it go. But you do that to somebody that has experience, you can't tell them this is the way it go. Nigga, you crazy. Man, who you think you talking to? They're going to go there with you. See, so the point I'm trying to make, like I said, once again, is for clarity. When you... just the things that you have done in your past, you women, and you men too, you shouldn't have to answer no questions in reference to whatever relationships you had. I mean, I kicked it with so-and-so, cool. But for us, details about what you did and how you did this and we did this and fellatio that and this position that and this that. No. You should never have to go into details about no past relationships with nobody, man. As simple as that. And like I told you, When you're sitting there, that's your first warning sign that something seriously is wrong with this situation. If somebody asks you questions over and over again, they telling you what kind of relationship it's going to be. It's going to be a stalking type relationship. It's going to be a paranoid type relationship. It's going to be a relationship that you're going to be on the edge. Those are the first warning signs, young ladies. I'm telling you, those. Anytime somebody want to sit there and want to know the guy you was with shoe size and all this other kind of, you know what I mean? Yeah, all this other kind of stuff. Look, that's your first warning sign, man. You know, somebody trying to meet you, they trying to meet you. You know what I'm saying? And at least you say about things. Because like I say, we know anyway, you know from experience that we do things. So we don't have to talk about our past. You got one, I got one. You know what I'm saying? So we don't have to talk about who we've been with. I'm talking about you now. You know, I'm talking about you and I'm talking about me. You understand? Once you say, I ain't no virgin, okay. You know, that's it. You don't have to say no more. Hey, man, look, that's real talk. Hey, man, that's what I got for you. I heard something. I thought about something. And like I said, it don't be personal. It's just clarity. We just want to be clear about a few things. You guys haven't, you understand? I don't come to you with the Bible in my hand, but it's always about God.
Operator.